Hello, my name is David Simakov. I'm professor of chemical engineering at the University of Waterloo. In my lab, we are developing technologies for renewable synthetic fuels and chemicals. Just to explain briefly the idea, like plants can make organic matter from water and carbon dioxide using solar energy, we can also take water and carbon dioxide and we can make lots of synthetic fuels and chemicals from these two chemical compounds. We can make methanol, we can make renewable natural gas, we can make renewable diesel, even gasoline, polymers, and many other materials which we can use in our industry and everyday life. The concept is that we can use renewable energy. For example, we can use solar panels or wind turbines. We can use this renewable power in order to split water into hydrogen and oxygen in a process which is called electrolysis. And then we can use this renewable hydrogen to react it with CO2, with carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide can be even extracted from the atmosphere, or we can take carbon dioxide from different anthropogenic sources, from different sectors of industry, or we can even use biogas or landfill gas as a source of carbon dioxide. Now, in order to react CO2, carbon dioxide, with renewable hydrogen to make these synthetic compounds, fuels and chemicals, we need catalytic materials, so-called catalysts. These catalysts are required in order to accelerate chemical reaction so that we can do it in a fast and efficient way. Actually, much, much faster than plants do. These catalytic materials are typically made from metals, oxygen, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, and these compounds are called metal oxides, metal carbides, metal nitrides, and so on. In our lab, we are developing these catalytic materials, and it's very important to develop and understand these materials at nanoscale. So we're also doing a lot of characterization. In order to use these materials for practical applications, we also need to develop conversion devices, so-called chemical reactors, that can incorporate these catalytic materials. So this is another thing we're doing in our lab. We are designing these chemical devices, these chemical reactors. We are testing them on a lab scale, and we are doing a mathematical modeling as well. And finally, in order to make this process practical and economically viable, we have to develop the entire system so that we can incorporate these chemical reactors in this process, large-scale process, and this process should be optimized, and we can do it using different chemical engineering modeling tools. The ultimate goal of our research is to develop sustainable technologies for a sustainable future, for decarbonizing our economy. We can use these renewable synthetic fuels during the transition period from fossil fuels-based economy to net carbon zero economy of the future. Thank you very much for listening.